Today I'm going to be showing you how to make these popular colorings on Premiere Pro for your edits. This is what the finished result looks like. And also, for your information, you're going to need the Sapphire plugin and also the Magic Bullet plugin to achieve this effect. Alright, so to begin, you want to create an adjustment layer. So head to your project tab, right click, new item, adjustment layer, and click OK. Place it on top of your clip. And then the first effect that we're going to add on is Sapphire Sharpen. So this one right here, S_sharpen, add it to your adjustment layer. And what I'm going to do is I'm just going to quickly read out these settings. So small detail size, this should be 3. Small details should be 2. And the medium details should also be 2. That's it for the S Sharpen. So I'm going to collapse this. The next effect I'm going to add is Unsharp Mask. Not the Sapphire version, if there is one, it's the built-in one. So this one underneath Blur and Sharpen, Unsharp Mask, so add that onto your adjustment layer. And you want to set both the amount and radius to 25, and it should look like this. So I'm going to collapse that as well. The next effect we're going to add is Magic Bullet Looks, right here. So add that onto your adjustment layer and click on Edit. So the first effect that we're going to add is Contrast, which should be around here. So if you just open up the tools, just hover your cursor and it should open this panel. So contrast, this one right here, you want to set it to 0.175, like so. And then you want to add on spot exposure. So where is it? There you go, right there. Increase these stops to a value of 1 and the radius to 1.25, like so. Next, we're going to add haze flare. So it should be the one underneath camera. This one right here, add that on. And what you want to do is change the spillage to 10, softness 50, exposure 0, reflection you want to turn off, and then the matte box size and also the shade both to 0, like so. Underneath the tint color, you're going to see RGB. Set all of these to 1, so from 0.7 to 1, and also B to 1. The next effect is Colorista, which is underneath color creation. So add that on. The first thing you're going to do is change the saturation. So from 100 to around 50, just play around with it, see what works best. I do recommend keeping it from 50 to 75. Anything higher or lower won't really look as good unless that's the intentional look you're trying to go for. Anyways, one more thing we need to do with Colorista, and that's move this curve down. So the lower half, what we want to do is just click and drag it down, so it should look something like this. It doesn't matter if it's not perfect, just make it look similar to my graph. And that's it for this Magic Bullet Looks effect. We're going to add one more. So first of all, we're going to save this, click on this tick icon here at the bottom. So there you go. I'm also going to collapse this effect. So once again, Magic Bullet Looks, one more time, we're going to open this up. So click on Edit, and the first effect we're going to add is exposure. So this one right here, you want to set these stops to -0.2. Now we're going to add some glow, so look for the optical diffusion effect. So add that on. You want to set the density to 10, the glow to 0.25, so this one right here, 0.25, and the quality from production to extreme. The next part is optional if you want some RGB splits around your clip, and it does look kind of cool, so I would recommend adding it on. So this one underneath camera, chromatic aberration, add that on. For the red sign, change this to 0.7 and the blue slash yellow to -0.5. So before and after, you can see there's an RGB split around the edge. And finally, we're going to add Colorista one more time. And what we're going to do is raise the upper half of this curve for RGB. So just copy what I do, raise it slightly high, like so. That looks fine. So we're going to save this, click on the checkbox here, and minimize this effect. Next, we're going to add Sapphire Glow. So search up S_glow underneath Sapphire Lighting. So Sapphire Glow, adjustment layer. These settings will depend on your clip. Some will require a brightness to be higher, some will require it to be way lower, and the same applies to the glow width. So these are the two main settings that you need to look out for. For my clip, I found that 0.5 for the glow and 125 for the glow width looks perfect. So if I were to set it to, if I was to set the brightness to something higher, for example, 1, you can see it looks really nice, but it looks a little overexposed, almost dreamlike. So that's not really what I want to go for. I want to make it look visible. So I think 0.5 looks better. The brightness is quite literally the brightness, so how strong it is, and the glow width is how far it spreads. So the higher, the further it spreads. But if you're happy with your settings, then collapse this effect. We're going to add one last one, which is brightness and contrast underneath color correction. So add this onto your adjustment layer. And all you need to do is set both of these to 15. And you're pretty much done. One very last thing I do want to mention before closing off, please feel free to play around with these settings, because these are just my recommended settings, right? Even these right here, 15 for both, it doesn't look very good for my clip. So I could set it to something like 5 for both and already it's looking better. Or maybe I could go for 5 brightness and then 10 for the contrast. And hey, that looks great. It's simply a matter of preference. And also I'm going to show you how to save this as a preset. So all you need to do is hold control on your keyboard and you want to click the effects starting from the top. So hold control, click S sharpen, unsharp mask, magic bullet, both of these, and then S glow, brightness, contrast, right click on one of them, say preset, give it a name. So it could be anything like quality coloring test, and then just click OK. Head into effects and search for that. So quality, and there it is underneath presets. So you can just drag and drop it onto other adjustment layers and it will apply all of these effects immediately. If you want to grab this preset with other coloring presets with various styles such as warm and cold, make sure to check out Enger's premium preset pack in the description below. There are 50 presets in total, from colorings to shakes to effects and transitions. So if you'd like to check it out, the link is in the description below. Check out this tutorial here if you are interested. Otherwise, thank you very much for watching and I'll see you next time. Peace.